I'm here with Bob today, and he's agreed to do a video tour of his rig that he built out. When did you build it, Bob?
Last year.
All right. Well,
it took me almost a full year.
I can believe it. Okay, so it's a cargo trailer. Pocket doors. Nifty.
This is the trailer. Oh,
yeah, I'm ducking right now under the bed, which I'll come around here and show. We're just gonna start with the bed just for the heck of it. So tell me about the bed, Bob.
It's on a Happy Jack bed lift. It's a full-size queen memory foam mattress. And it's awesome because I don't have to make my bed when people come into my rig. I can just shove it up against the ceiling and nobody knows what it looks like.
So, yeah, it raises up and down. And yeah, I believe you told me it can be lowered to just whatever point you want it to be
right,
at, right?
But I usually lower it down to the top of these cushions on the benches.
Okay.
Gives him plenty of room underneath and gives me, it's still easy enough for me to get up on there. But yeah, just
him. It gives Archie here plenty of room underneath.
And I just use the button to raise and lower it, and gives me room as like a living room.
Uh-huh,
and
very cool.
Still a full queen size bed.
Right.
Wow. And
everything in here I use
as is.
I shouldn't say everything. Most things I use that I have in here I use all the time or want to have easily available. Mm-hmm. Everything else I put in the back of the truck, so I don't, you know, it's in there. It's not the easiest thing to always get stuff out, but if I only use it once or twice a year, three times a year, it doesn't make sense to try to carry the trailer.
Okay.
And I'm still, this is my first real trip with it.
Mm-hmm.
Getting back on the road full time, and I'm still organizing, getting rid of stuff. When you go from a 6-foot by 10-foot trailer to one that's over double the square footage, you learn to carry too much crap. Which I think every one of us goes through, so.
True that.
So, okay.
You were explaining to me about the couches, that you can make more bedding out of couches.
I can sleep over on this side because it's wide enough that you can sleep a single person on here if you wanted to.
Mm-hmm.
There's nights that I don't feel like putting the bed down because I'm tired or whatever, and I'll just crash right on here.
Okay.
And it's comfortable. I mean, it's not the best, but it's comfortable for sure.
And then somebody also could sleep on the other one.
Yeah, you'd have to be a little bit smaller, but...
Yeah.
Because this one's only... The cushion's only like 24 inches wide, and this one I think is 26 or 28.
Okay.
So you get a little bit more room there.
Okay.
But yeah, you could easily... I've taken a nap out here, so it's not that bad.
Okay. Then we'll work our way to the kitchen here.
Most important part of the trailer.
love that you know have that top space for storage of miscellaneous items.
Yep.
And then I assume that's got a lip on it to hold things in place, right?
It's the 1.5-inch lip around there. So
okay, and you built these cabinets from scratch, is that correct?
Yep, I bought raw lumber and milled it all down for the frames, the door frames, as well as the frames of the cabinet. And then just covered them with a little bit of plywood on the ends and top and bottom. And it's the first thing I designed for this trailer was a kitchen.
And love these snaps, and I think you made those also, right?
Yes, I did. Everything in the trailer, everything, cabinets, all that I built myself.
Uh-huh.
I had help with, some of the stuff like the solar and... awning and then the bed lift.
Where did you find your inserts for your cabinet doors?
Those are all charts from when I was in the Coast Guard. I spent 9 years in the Coast Guard and kind of kept charts from most of the places I was stationed.
Oh.
Just kind of gives it a nautical feel and kind of brings back some memories of those, which times faded the bad ones and let me keep the good ones. So
there you go. And I see you have a nice, really nice size fridge, which is wonderful.
Yeah, it's got its drawbacks. Like, now I buy too much food when I go to the store. But, I mean, other than that, I love it. And, you know, got a nice size freezer so I can actually get some frozen stuff.
That's like the part I love.
Yeah.
Yeah. And so I love the sink. A lot of thought went into that, I'm sure.
Yeah,
so
you except can... for I mismeasured my cabinet, so my faucet doesn't quite go up in place.
Oh, well.
Yeah.
It still works, right?
It still works. Yep.
Yeah, yeah. I love that it's a deep sink and the tall faucet, so you can do just about anything with that.
I use it for just cleaning up in between showers. And, you know, being in a wheelchair, my hands just get trashed, so it's really nice for that.
Excellent.
I can actually get them good and clean, so.
Uh-huh. Okay, and then explain to me how you did this backsplash.
It's just aluminum that you would use, that you could get at, like, Home Depot or Lowe's.
Like aluminum flashing?
Flashing, thank you.
Okay.
So it's aluminum flashing, and I found a video on YouTube that a guy that did it, and what you use is a roller like you put the spline for screens in life.
Right.
So it's got...
So window screening?
No.
They have a thing that's called a spline roller.
Yep. And then I just laid out 45-degree angles, rolled over it, and it came out awesome.
I think it did. That is so creative and so beautiful at the same time.
Yeah.
And you have a nice oven. I'm always jealous of
which
ovens.
Which is awesome for extra storage.
Storage,
space.
Yes, that's what most people say. But yep. If you want to bake something, you
can. I made enchiladas last night in there. So
nice. And I would assume you can bake a pizza in there.
Already done that.
So, and looks like it's a three-burner stove.
Three-burner stove.
Nice. Oh, that is beautiful. So I assume it's propane, probably.
Yep. Those are propane. This is just a fridge from like Lowe's. One of the college fridges is just a little bit bigger, so that's just 110.
So you've got solar. How much solar do you have?
1,000 watts.
And my goodness. And what about your batteries?
200 amp hour lithium.
And you're able to run that and anything else, any of your other needs?
Yeah, like 3 days. I've got an electric kettle that I use for making coffee in the morning. And, you know, that it runs that and the refrigerator. And I don't really use a lot of 110, but.
This is all of your control panel and all that kind of stuff.
Yep.
Oh, you don't use 110 except for the fridge and the kettle?
I mean, and my computer, but
okay.
It's I don't really have a lot, but I wanted enough solar, and when I get a bigger inverter, I can get like a toaster oven and then use that and not have to use the propane all the time.
Yeah.
And, you know, with 1,000 watts of solar, that should just easily make up for it.
So. That is beautiful. Okay. And then, gosh, you have so much cabinet space. It's amazing.
Yep.
Now, I love how you've hung your pots and pans here.
Yeah. One of the little indulgences I gave myself was carrying all my copper pots and pans.
And I failed to ask you this the other day. What's in this tall cabinet here? Is that clothing?
This one?
Uh-huh.
This is all my jackets.
Okay. Okay. So you're hanging. And what's behind the door where your pots and pans hang?
Let me show you real quick. Watch that. So this is extra storage.
Nice.
All my tools. And then two charge controllers. One for, there's 500 going to each one. So if I need to, I can shut one off. Or if I want to.
Perfect.
Got a 2,000 watt. Pure sine wave inverter with an automatic transfer switch. So if I plug into electricity, it automatically switches all the 110 over to shore power.
That's perfect.
And then, like I said, just extra storage for stuff I don't use, but like to have close, like a lot of my tools and like, you know, heavier jackets because sometimes it gets cold out here. So.
Right, right. Oh, I didn't even notice the storage tucked away back in there.
Yeah, in the corner.
Oh, that is perfect. So you really, really made great use of every inch of this place because that's the pointed nose of your trailer, which does not really come across on the video.
It's a V-nose trailer.
Right, a V-nose, that's right. And so, yes, that's beautiful. And why such a thick door?
I got it insulated
uh-huh.
with an inch of foam or inch and a half of foam.
Okay.
Just to make sure that A, that area stays warm if it's really cold out, so the lithium, I can still charge it.
Okay.
And then the other thing is that when it's really hot out, it helps keep that cool.
Okay.
So that, you know, everything's not running really hot.
Right. That's very smart. And then, is that tongue and groove?
Tongue and groove cedar. Yep.
Okay. It's beautiful. Anything else that you want to tell me about your living space here?
Again, propane stove.
That's okay.
You know, I've got the vent hood. I was trained as a chef, and like I said, the kitchen was the first thing I designed because I was in a 6-foot by 10-foot before, cooking everything on a little one burner butane stove or a 2-burner Coleman stove, and I was just like, no, I want a countertop that I can cut on and use as prep space. I want a good stove and oven, and, you know, that was it. So
isn't this just a beautiful countertop? I mean, my goodness, that's so pretty.
Like, for heat, I just have one of the diesel heaters, and that keeps it
quite
warm in here.
Uh-huh. And is this one of the vents for that?
Yep, that is.
So you're enjoying that, huh?
Max air fan to help pull air through.
Okay.
But I've got strip LEDs that are RGBWs on both sides of the trailer. And then I've got puck lights in the ceiling here and underneath the bed.
Perfect.
It's all LED and all got cabinet lights underneath as well. So I can light up.
Oh, nice. Yeah. I bet. Oh, I can see. Yeah. Just little strip lights there. And you told me you bring someone with you in your travels. And I've got the camera on him right now. Who's that?
That's a picture of my dad. We always went camping as a family when I was growing up. And I figured I'd take him on the road with me because love camping, so
that's perfect.
He goes everywhere with me.
You showed me a piece of your artwork earlier today.
Yeah, I wound up actually getting it back up on the wall finally. It fell off when I was on my way down here, so
very pretty. Yeah, I got it in an earlier shot as well. That's very nice.
Thank you.
Beautiful. All right, do you have any other hobbies that you do on the road?
Oh boy. Sit in the sun, have fun, play Farkle.
That's right.
That's got to be one of the biggest ones.
Got to play the Farkle.
Yeah. I don't know. We're at Van 8, so I've just been trying to help out where I can. And mostly I'm winding up sitting and talking to people about my trailer. It seems like everybody that walks by just is amazed at it. So.
Yes, it's such a great build. So functional, so clean, so, you know, such a pleasing space. And, you know, it's an inspiration for people that they're trying to build something to live in because you have everything you need.
Yeah, spending 2 years in a 6x10, I really figured out what I wanted. And the build evolved as I was doing it. And you can't be afraid of going, oh, I thought this would work here, but it doesn't. And just switching things up.
Uh-huh.
And then, you know, you just put your head down and do it. This took me a full year to do, like I said, and I'm happy with the way it came out. And so far, there's been nothing that I'd want to change.
I do also think that your experience with being on the road before, how long were you on the road again before you built this? So 2 years, that also gave you a lot of knowledge about what you did want, how you wanted things arranged.
Looking at other people's rigs and, you know, just coming up with ideas. And for me, having to build around my wheelchair, so I knew I didn't want my cabinet sticking out or a lot of stuff. I wanted it to feel airy. And I just kind of sat down and thought about it and thought about it. And I mean, I thought about it for a full year and just made, whenever I came up with something, would make notes in a book. And most of it's here.
Perfect.
I mean,
that's
I would
great.
Love to have I was looking for a trailer that had a steep ravino so I could put a wet bath in, but you know, it didn't work out, but I'm okay with that.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, it works out for me. So
okay. With that being said, what do you do for your bathing purposes?
Again, I just use the sink and some warm water and Dr. Bronner's, and like once a week I'll run into town and take a shower.
Okay.
I usually use the truck stops because they actually have handicap showers.
Okay.
So.
Network
and
stuff.
When I'm out by myself or out in the woods, I actually have a 2-gallon, one of the old-fashioned 2-gallon water fire extinguishers that I just put a shower end on, and I'll just, it's painted flat black, so I'll fill it up, let it sit in the sun all day, and then I've got a little pop-up thing that I can just jump in there and clean up really quick.
Perfect.
Yeah. It's not the best, but, you know, you get 2 gallons and that's it. So
it doesn't take much to shower. No. That's one thing us nomads do learn, is that it really does not take very much water to shower.
And when you get used to conserving it, yeah, it's pretty quick.
Yeah, I it's kind of weird whenever I get to have a full-on shower now, because I'm so used to conserving water that, you know, I'm tempted to just turn it off, but I usually go, full water.
That's it. It's like, my hair's never felt so clean, it's like you can just stand there and feel the dirt washing away.
It's almost like that the hills are alive with music kind of experience or something.
It's a good feeling.
Okay, thank you.
I think people underappreciate how good showers are.
Yeah, they do, but that is something that in this lifestyle we do get to learn to appreciate, and I know I giggle to have a shower, and I'm so glad that I am that appreciative of it, and it sounds like you feel the same.
Oh yeah.
So well, thank you so much for showing us your beautiful home, Bob. And you know, I know I've been trying to keep you in the shade here. So anyway, we'll see you later, Bob.
All right, have a good one. We are heroes tonight.